this is basically something that I saw online, and it's an actual prosthetic, and I was like, you know what, I love prosthetics, but some prosthetics can be expensive and some are not. This one is not. So basically I'm going to show you how to make it yourself, because as I mentioned, a lot of my SFX videos, I love making prosthetics myself. So what I'm first going to do is I'm first going to be applying a layer of spirit gum on my nose area, where I'm going to be applying the wax. And I'm going to be taking my nose and scar wax. Make sure to buy one which is as close as possible to your skin color. And before you apply the nose wax, what you want to do is you want to tap it so that it becomes tacky. It automatically activates as you tap it. That's why I don't touch it really until I'm certain I'm going to put the wax on. Trying not to touch the wax with my fingers. To make this seam as if the nose is ripped off, we're going to extend my nose so it looks longer than it does, just to kind of give it an effect. And then we're going to apply this over it, another ball of wax like that, and we're going to push it into the skin. So now I'm going to take my Cinema Secrets primer, and I'm going to apply some on the back of my hand, pick it up with my fingers, and I'm going to be smoothing this out. So I'm just going to be applying another layer of wax over. I applied spirit gum and I applied that. So I'm just going to make this top layer a little bit thicker so I can work with it better. And then again, taking Cinema Secrets primer. It's silicone based, so it's going to help me smooth out everything. Okay, so now you guys can see that there's quite a lot of wax on my nose. So now I'm going to take Sigma's F11 brush, and I'm going to dip it into the silicone primer so that it helps me cut around the nose easier. And now I'm just going to the side, so the hole's going to start right up there. Okay, and then the second point's gonna be here, so right there, gonna cut that. Okay, and then when we're done with that, I'm gonna take my spatula and remove some of the wax. It's also best to dip the spatula into the primer. Okay, so that's what that part looks like right now. And now we're going to take this, push it down a bit with the spatula. It just goes a bit faster. And that hole which we cut here, I'm just gonna push it back like that. Make it unmessy, like it was skin removed or something like that. And this part also can be a little bit like that. This is a bone right there, so we're just gonna try to smooth it out as much as possible. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to again pick up that same brush from Sigma. It's the F11. We're going to lather it up with silicone. And what I want you to do is blend down these edges right there. To be picking up Sigma's F11 brush, and they kind of gave like a pasty blend, almost thick. And we're going to be applying this in certain areas. I like that it's not too thick, so it's easy to manipulate. And you can apply it. Oh, that's so nice how easy it is to drag. Okay, you want to apply like thick amounts in holes, and then you can drag it out a bit. This blood actually has quite a pleasant smell to it. Okay, so now using some liquid blood, I'm going to be picking up my Sigma FX10 and applying it on these areas. And then with my, FX9, I'm just going to be slowly dragging it out like that. Okay, since I'm not happy with how this part up here became, I'm going to take this brush that I used earlier, the F11 brush, and I'm picking up actually some wax and applying it to this area and changing it. I want more of this bone to kind of show, so again, picking up that same brush which I used earlier. So we're going to go back to Sigma's blood, the thick one. We're going to pick up a substantial amount. We're going to be applying it right there. Okay, now I'm going to apply a little bit more of the Sigma blood right here at the edges, because I can't apply any more wax on this area, but I want to make it seem as if the bone is going all the way down like this. And we're going to be applying more wax here to make it seem more like exploded. Okay, so this is okay, but I still want it to seem more exploded, so I'm applying even more wax here. And we're going to do something really interesting right now. I'm going to be lifting this wax like this. I'm going to be going back to this Sigma brush, the F11, lathering it up with the silicone primer. And just pushing it down right there. These edges, we don't want these edges to move at all. But we do want this part to go like that. Okay? Okay, now I removed some of the blood underneath the nose. And I'll explain why, because I just came up with an idea. I'm going to be applying spirit gum right there. And, because I want to make it like look like it explodes there, I'm going to make it tacky. I'm not sure if the spirit gum would become tacky with that fake blood. And now I'm applying wax here. Okay. I'm going to take my Sigma F11 brush and blending this guy into the skin. Don't forget to lather it up with Vaseline or silicone primer, something. We're done with that. We're going to take a bit more of Sigma blood. I'm using this guy up like it's going out of fashion. And I'm going to be applying it into this area right here like that. I'm going to be filling it all up like that. Putting a little bit on the tip of these guys. Okay. Now this looks connected. I don't want it to look connected, to look like it exploded like that. Okay. Again, we need a little bit more of Sigma Blood because we're making depth with it without using a black color. I'm gonna apply that right there and there. And we're gonna take a little bit more of the fake blood. Need some more fake blood just to look bloody. Okay guys, this is it. This is the nose that is kind of like exploded, ripped. I don't know what to call it. Officially it's like the shredded nose tip. And hopefully you guys do like it. Hopefully it's fun. Hopefully it looks realistic. Let me know in the comments below. And yeah, see you soon.